20,000 Volts Under the Sea, a rock and roll adventure by the Brian Waite Band. It was a typical day at the Brian Waite Band studio. Todd was eating seafood, Cliff was reading the paper, and Brian was playing guitar. Then, the door burst open, and the boss arrived with an announcement.
I have good news, rock and roll adventurers. I just booked y'all a gig at the Neptune Theater in Atlanta City.
Woo! All right.
Right on, man.
Hey, what are you waiting for? Get moving.
Yes, sir. Where's Atlanta City?
Oh, I almost forgot. You have to play an electric eel guitar during the concert, so don't forget to pick one up before you get to the gig, okay? Good. Have a great show.
An electric eel guitar?
What's that? I've never heard of it.
Yeah, we'll figure it out, guys. All right, looks like we're heading to the ocean. You know what that means.
To the sub!
The band loaded up their submarine, called the subwoofer, with their scuba gear and waterproof instruments, and ascended into the ocean.
We're off to Atlanta City on an underwater road trip. We're cruising down Bob Marlin Avenue.
As the band searched for Atlanta City, a strange-looking fish appeared and circled the sub. Curious, they put on their scuba gear and swam outside to investigate.
Wow! This fish makes music. I think it's a sea bass.
Hey, here comes a shark, and it has 12 strings. Cool.
And that looks like a drum fish over there. Hey, do you want to play some music with these guys?
Yeah!
Let's do it!
Well, the coral reef is coming alive to join us on this magical dive. Yeah, it's a happy time in the deep blue sea.
The band had lots of fun swimming and jamming with the sea creatures. Little did they know that drawn out of the murky depths by the noise and excitement was a hairy, scary sea monster.
Everybody hide! Hey, wait, stay down.
The ferocious beast drifted silently upwards until... snap! Its long, sharp teeth slashed at the band.
We've got to get away from this hungry fish.
Yeah, over here. There's a cave we can hide in.
Let's get in it quick.
Whew. That was close.
Yeah, that was really close.
Yeah, that was close.
Brian, is that you?
It's not Brian. It's me, Disco Don.
Disco Don?
Disco Don, getting real gone. Boogie woogie woogie into his favorite disco song. Hey there, Don, what's gone wrong? You say you want revenge on Brian, Cliff, and Tom.
Disco Don, what are you doing here?
Why, to make sure you never get to your show!
Now, why would you want to do that?
It's all part of my brilliant plan! When you fail to reach the Neptune Theater, I will show up to take your place. It's genius. Genius, I tell you! Ha, 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 ha.
While Disco Don rambled on about his evil plan, Cliff and Todd thought quickly.
Hey, Disco Don, listen, do you hear that?
Yeah, there's a party going on outside the cave. They're all doing the hustle, and they're chanting your name.
Oh, my goodness! Well, of course they are! I'm the king of the hustle! Here I come, adoring fans! Where are you all? Wait, what's that? Oh no! A hungry fish! Ah!
Oh, yeah!
Our plan worked out pretty well, huh?
Yeah, it works every time.
Hey, where's Brian?
I don't know. We have to find him.
Hey, Brian!
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 Suddenly, a dark shape loomed in the distance.
Hey, there's a dark shape looming in the distance. Brian, is that you?
It wasn't Brian. It was a whale, dressed in a dark suit and sunglasses.
I don't think that's Brian.
Who's doing all this yelling over here?
Sorry about that, Mr.
Why, where are my manners? Allow me to introduce myself. I'm a blues whale. My name is B.B.
Oh, hey, BB. Nice to meet you.
I'm Todd.
And I'm Cliff.
Well, that's nice. Why don't you hand me that guitar over there, and we can play some blues together. From the tip of my hat to the fluke of my tail, I'm the sea mammal they call the blues whale. Don't have a pod, I only have a band.
BB enjoyed playing music with the guys so much that when they told him they were looking for an electric eel guitar, he decided to help them.
I don't know where to find one of those, but my friend the Rocktopus surely will.
Cool. Where does he live?
The Rocktopus lives deep in the ocean, in a funky place called the Mariana Groove. Whoa, look at the time. I gotta get going, boys. Good luck to y'all.
Right, hey, thanks, take care, BB.
As he swam out of sight, waving his tail, he passed by the wreckage of a pirate ship and spotted Brian inside, still hiding from the hungry fish.
Hey, guys! Guys! Guys!
Brian! We found you!
You're okay!
Yeah, I'm good now. Luckily, a nice old whale came by, and he told me the coast was clear.
Yeah, that was BB. He helped us out, too. That guy was cool.
Cliff and Todd told Brian about the Rocktopus while they pulled themselves back into the sub and prepared to descend.
Wow. Sounds like we have to take this sub down pretty deep.
Yeah.
We gotta get down.
Gotta get down.
Get on up.
Gotta get down.
Get on down.
Gotta get down, 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 down.
Feeling good.
Gotta get down.
Get up, get up.
Gotta get down.
Get down in your submarine.
Gotta get down, 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 down.
The subwoofer shook and groaned as it sunk beneath the sun's rays and into a deep, dark abyss. High canyon walls rising in the sub's headlights were the band's only clue that they were entering the Mariana Groove.
Man, I hope this subwoofer holds together.
Guys, we got a leaky pipe.
Don't worry, we'll be fine. I'll be in the engine room fixing the pipes.
Cliff had just left the cockpit when, bang! The sub hit rock bottom, and all of the lights went out.
There's something moving out there.
It's just dirt kicked up by
Who dares disturb my groove?
All of a sudden, a mass of multicolored glowing tentacles lit up and waved outside the sub. There were gnashing, crunching sounds as a giant octopus grabbed the sub, shoved it down his throat, and ate it. The end. Just kidding. Actually, they were fine, and they'd found the Rocktopus.
Oh, no!
Don't hurt us, Mr. Rocktopus.
We come in peace.
We're friends of BB.
Oh, BB, eh? Hey, how's he doing anyway?
Oh, wait, he's fine.
Yeah, he sent us down here because he said that you might be able to, perhaps...
Maybe, if you want to, you don't have to.
If it's not too much trouble.
And if it is...
Whoa, hey, you guys, you gotta relax. I mean, what is it that you're trying to say here anyway?
Well, we wanted to ask you if, do you know where we can find an electric eel guitar?
Well, as a matter of fact, I do. I've got one in my band.
Delighted at their good fortune, Brian and Todd told the Rocktopus about their gig in Atlantis City and asked him if they could hire his electric eel guitar for the show.
I tell you what, I'll let you hire him on one condition. Y'all got to prove that you can groove.
All right. Yeah, man. You're talking to the Rocktopus here.
What I want to know is, can you prove that you can groove?
The band kicked into a super funky beat, which really grooved. The Rocktopus danced and even joined in the jam before judging Brian and Todd worthy of their prize.
All right. You guys sure can get funky. You know the electric seal sitar will be honored to rock with you. In fact, here she is, Todd.
Oh, well, thanks.
Hey, hold on a sec. That's very nice and all, but we need an electric eel guitar.
Oh, hey, why didn't you say so? Well, now, listen up. All's I know is that electric eel guitars have been known to hang out with the AC/DC crowd.
The band?
No, silly lamb walker. The AC/DC, the Atlantis City Drift Current, leads right to Atlanta City.
He pointed to a giant frothy swirl in the distance. A slightly charred Todd gingerly set the electric seal sitar down. He and Brian went to tell Cliff the good news. With the sub repaired, the band set a course for the turbulent AC/DC. As they entered the AC/DC, the current grabbed the subwoofer and threw it spinning forward. Schools of Neil Perch, Alice Groupers, and Steely Head Dans flashed by the portholes.
Whoa, look at all these amazing fish. This is awesome.
I hear you, man. Hey, what do you think, Todd? Todd?
Todd wasn't listening. He was too busy trying to locate the source of the delicious smell wafting across his nose. He followed it to the sub's door.
There it is. A seafood platter floating just outside the sub. Must have it.
No! You know, there's something fishy going on here.
Don't do it, Todd. Don't open that door.
Come back into the sub.
Gotcha!
Disco Don getting real gone.
It was Disco Don. He had lured Todd into a trap and was reeling him in. Brian and Cliff rushed to the sub's steering wheel and tried desperately to follow Todd, but it was no use. The AC/DC was in control and dragging them to Atlanta City. They frantically thought of outlandish rescue plans before sitting in silence, staring out of the portholes. Suddenly, something slammed into the sub, its face pressed against the glass.
What the?
Hello, dear man. Sorry about the bump.
Skank and Jaw? Is that you?
Yeah, man.
Cliff, give me a hand. Help me pull him in.
Yeah, okay, here you go, Skank and Jaw.
Thank you, me friends.
You know, what in the world are you doing out there?
Well, was doing the bumbo on a pirate ship, you know. The thing sprung a leak and sunk to the bottom of the ocean.
Oh, no, man.
No problem, man. These things happen. But anyway, what you doing down here, me good friends?
Well, we're heading to Atlanta City, but we're having some troubles. We haven't found an electric eel guitar.
Yeah, and Todd's been captured by Disco Don, and we can't even get him because we're caught in this current.
Well, everything gonna work out, man. You'll find Todd and the eel, no problem. All you got to do is go with the flow. Listen here. Oh, here's what you got to know. If you just learn to let go now, life takes you where you need to be. Don't fight it, man. Come on and sing with me. Oi!
Go with the flow, man. Go with the flow.
We are gonna go with the flow. Oh, man.
The reggae rhythms made everyone feel better. Brian and Cliff were confident that the AC/DC would take care of them. They were sure glad that Skink and Jaw had shown up.
Oi! There's me exit. That'll take me right back to Jamaica, man. Thanks for the ride, me good friends.
Take care, man. Have a good one.
Brian and Cliff waved as Skink and Jaw climbed out of the subwoofer and into the Jamaican current. Then they looked at each other and laughed. While they were walking back to their stations, Brian noticed a glowing creature swimming by the sub. It was an electric eel guitar. And drifting quietly behind it was Todd.
Cliff, look!
Hey, it's Todd! And he's found an electric eel guitar.
Quiet, you guys. Almost have him. Almost have him. Got it! Oh, no! Come back here!
The chase is on. The chase is on. The chase is on. Go, 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 go!
Everybody, stop! Mr. Electric Eel, we are the Brian Waite Band.
Yeah, and we need your help.
Yeah, that's right. We need an electric eel guitar. We were hoping that you could play in our show today.
The eel scratched his chin with his tail. He looked carefully at Brian, Todd, and Cliff, and pondered. Finally, he nodded and started swimming toward the band.
He's gonna do it, guys!
All right, you know, thank awesome. You so yeah, much. Yeah. That's great.
Now we can play our gig.
Right. Yeah, let's get going.
Gotcha again!
Oh no! It's Disco Dawn!
Disco Dawn, getting real good.
I'll take this eel! Now the gig is mine, boys! I win! You lose!
No way, Don! This isn't over yet!
But Disco Dawn had already sped off with the electric eel to get to the Neptune Theater first. Brian, Cliff, and Todd scissor-kicked back to the subwoofer, determined to beat Disco Dawn and rescue the electric eel guitar. Todd engaged the clap thrusters, and moments later, through the swirling current, they spotted the neon glow of Atlantis City.
There it is! Atlantis City.
Wow. It's amazing.
Look at those golden spires.
Yeah, look at the lights.
Look at the direction, somebody. I don't know where we're going.
Well, let's ask that pilot whale. Excuse me, sir. Oh, sorry. Ma'am, how do we get to the Neptune Theater?
As fate would have it, the pilot whale was heading to see the show, and they followed her all the way there. The theater was full, the audience was excited, and the anglerfish were just dimming the lights.
Ladies and gentlefish, my name is Ray Leno. Welcome to the Neptune Theater. Wow, look at all of you. You're packed in here today, aren't you? Is this a theater or a can of sardines? You know, I've got a million of them, folks, but seriously, you're not here to watch my gills flap. You're here to rock out, right? Right. So without further ado, let's give a wet Atlantis City welcome to... Hey, wait a minute. Who are you?
Thank you, Ray. And hello, my fans.
What's this? Get off the stage, man.
I will not. Don't you know who I am? I'm Disco Dawn.
Get off the stage.
The Disco Dawn. I'm famous! Famous, I tell you! And a million times better than that Brian Waite band!
We want the Brian Waite band! We want the Brian Waite band!
Look, I brought the electric eel guitar! I'll play it for you! And you'll see that I'm the greatest musician of all time! Here we go! One, two, ready!
I'll take that, Disco Dawn.
It was Brian, dog paddling onto the stage with his bandmates.
Hello, Atlantis City!
Are you ready to rock?
Yeah! He's a rare guitar that swims. He's part fish, part lightning.
The Neptune Theater crowd went crazy as the band started to jam. Brian cranked up the eel's volume fin to 11, and when the blues whale and the rocktopus joined in, the crowd went into a frenzy. Yes, it was just another day at the office for the Brian Waite band. And for these guys, every day at the office is a rock and roll adventure.
He's a superstar, electric eel guitar. He's a superstar, electric eel guitar.
To order the book version of 20,000 Volts Under the Sea, or get the CD, or just learn more about Brian Waite Band's rock and roll adventures, go to www.brianwaite.com. Have fun!